I couldn't wait. I wanted to see what it looked like. That's gonna be clean in her setup. What it do, gang? It's your boy, Elko Warren, and you know I'm up in the rock shop. All right, y'all, I'm back up. And yeah, my other video should be up, man, same day. That's the life of a night site worker. But yeah, so in my last vid, gang, we got it cracking on these heads. We got that bolt out of there on both of them. It was three of them. Where did I put it? I need to clean up. It started getting wild as hell up in here. But yeah, so what we ended up doing, gang, is this is what broke off down inside the head. And I kept looking at it. And I was like, you know what? If I take like a bolt put over, an oversized bolt put over there, and put a nice little puddle in there, it'll grab onto that thing and I'll be able to pull it out. So we got that cracking, and now these should have no problem sealing up. Now, the reason why that bolt was in there, the head stud was in there, valve cover bolt was in there, is I converted these over from center bolt, and center bolt is like the name says, center bolt. It bolts down the center over to perimeter style. Those valve covers are up in that box because I like the perimeter style better. They have a lot more options, but I decided to go ahead and put this motor back to stock. And so that's what, you know, today's thing is we will be pulling the frame out later. I asked the auntie to pull the race car back some. So we'll be getting on the frame today. And once it's this simple now, again, once I put secure the brake lines down, I can make the frame back up. We're done. This guy is done. We got this all finished up. That's good to go. What else? We got this over here finished up. Man, my poster guy Sergio. I posted a video of his Malibu, man. He's got a clean 78. If you care to check it out, it's further up in the video selections. But he was like, man, you got a lot going on. So, man, we got the Malibu lines. I just got the Malibu lines going on. Malibu stuff. But we finished up her sending unit. There's one last thing I got to do. I was trying to put one of these compression fittings on here, but it just will not fit. This must be, I done sanded it and did all kind of stuff. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna flare it back out and just run the holes to it. I'm gonna flare it back out like that. You feel me? So, but we're done there. I had finished it, but the holes that I had on here, I was unsure if it was high PSI. So young Elko Marcus, he blessed me with a nice little piece of 400 PSI hose. And so we went ahead and cut that thing up and got it on there. So she official now, she done. We also have the end piece on here. I just need to run the wires in here, stab them up in there, and we good to go. So we got the quick disconnect on there, ground, power, and the sending unit signal. So we are good to go there, gang. But today, what we gonna be getting after is cleaning up this block. Now it's time to get this thing back together. Everything's still separated. So I was saying before, man, let's say if you have a seasoned motor, one that's been in service for a while, you don't want to put this lifter in that spot, that lifter in this spot, this lifter in it. You want to put everything back where it was. If I got these out of order on this block, it only has 1,200 miles. So I don't think that's really going to cause any situations. You feel me? So what we did last, man, is that we painted this thing up. And it is looking real good, real good. But what we want to do now, gang, is we want to take the pan off. So I'm going to pull it out, flip it over, take the pan out, and start blowing everything out, every little nook and cranny. Something went through this motor. Not from me, though. That's the killer part, because when I emptied that pan, that pan was clean. The motor oil still was, you know, new looking. But from when I first got this done, something ran through here, man. So I'm gonna blow it out real good. And just to make sure everything is all out. you know, that could have happened on the first few oil, you know, first couple of oil changes. That's back when I was dealing with shops. But yeah, gang, so we're gonna get after this, man. Hook up the air hose, start blowing this all out, flip it over, start blowing it all out, and then get to those heads. Let me get back over there and show y'all that. Get back to these heads over here, man. And same thing, we're gonna clean them all up, blow them all out, you know, make sure there's no crap up in there, and get them in primer, or, you know, seal them all up, tape them all off, get them in primer, and then paint them up black and keep it moving and start getting this motor put back together. So let me get on that. I'll set you guys down and fade you guys back in. All right, y'all. And we faded back on in Chevy Country. All right, gang. So I have just done a thorough cleaning of everything, blowing it all out, wiping everything down with the lint-free situations. And we are good. You know, we are good to go, gang. So she's already on top dead center, but I'll be rotating it and all that stuff. And that's really easy to find at this point as far as top dead center on the compression stroke is what you want. I got a whistle that as it's the air's coming up, it's like beep. And then when the whistle finally settles, this is where it stopped. When the whistle was gone, that was right at zero. See that line? And this is top dead center. That's it. But yeah, you get top dead center on twice. You're on the compression stroke and then on the other stroke. But there it is, gang. So what we're about to do now is we're about to start putting all these lifters and all that stuff back in place. The last thing I'll do is put the oil pan on. So I'm not really tripping on that. But we're going to get these guys back in their spots. So, and I'm going to have to turn this block back around the way I had it, so I get everything back in the correct spot. So that's what we're gonna get after. I gotta hit my homeboys up. These are the ones that came on it, but I have this same set, but it has a roller tip on it. And I wanna get their opinions on if I should put those in. It's a new set. They were meant for this motor. And I think they might be on those heads. I'm not sure, I might take them off. But yeah, gang, we got a little bit before we get to that. So I'm going to go ahead and oil these guys up with some Ultra Slick and Cam Shield. All of that doesn't really need to be done anymore because it's already broken in. And this is a roller motor, so roller motors, you don't need to break the cam in. But we already drove this 1,200 miles, so we good there. But just to get some Ultra Slick on it, so when everything starts back up, moving and grooving, it is, you know, lubed. So there it is, gang. I'm going to get after it and bring you guys back on. Yes, sir. All right, gang. So we hooked it up. Little Ultra Slick, engine assembly lube, and some cam shield. We lubed her up. Everything just dropped right back in. This system worked out great in order for me to get everything put back in order. And now we are done with that. So the bag is about to come out, and that's where she going to sit. You feel me? Now we about to start in on these heads. So let me get after this, gang. I'm gonna set you guys down and get this bag covered over. And that's it, man. So moving and grooving, and we're gonna get the heads taken care of. Then we'll be pulling the frame out. That's a different video, but that's what we're gonna get after, man. All right, y'all, fading it out. All right, gang, we fading it back in. Me and my terrible tape job. But yeah, you see I got it all the way around the edges, and I tried to go back beyond just a little bit to get all the blue. I didn't care about all of this in here, man. Don't worry about it. Got some numbers on there, but oh well. We got the bottoms, the back, pretty much everywhere done. I'll go back over and make sure it's all clean. And we're going to scuff it up real nice and get that primer on there. All right, y'all, fading it on out. Fading it back on in. All right, gang, we got it in primer. Ran out of black paint, so I gotta run up the street right quick. I kind of just been scooching everything up inside. Yeah, I said scooching. The other one's good to go. Probably put another coat on there. That's maybe two coats. Just light, kind of just filled it in till the can ran out. Block is good to go. Yeah. So we gonna keep pushing forward, man. You know, it takes a long ass time. The painting and primering is nothing. It's the actual masking and taping off. That shit takes forever. You know, you want to keep the surfaces clean. Man, I think I might get the spray mask if I ever do this again. But yeah, gang, looking good. I'm going to head on up here and get this black paint. And I really want to put them on the motor, see how everything looks. Yeah, we're going to fade it back in a minute, gang. It's looking pretty good. All right. And we fading back on the end. All right, man, I've been all over trying to, damn, it's already dark. I've been all over trying to find some damn paint. Couldn't find it, so I had to get some engine enamel. The other one was a Robar and chassis. So we just gonna hit that one again over there, get this one cracking and be done with it. So yeah. All right, gang, so we gonna get after it. And I was hoping to be on that frame, man. Sheesh. But I'm telling you, the masking, that's what takes forever. It don't take no time to paint. You know what I mean? You just mix the paint up and start doing your thing. But that tape off, that back mask, all that, even the littlest of stuff. This one here, because I didn't have a razor blade, was taking forever. But we got it done. Shit, we ain't gonna complain. All right, y'all, I'm gonna get after it. Get it sprayed up and get it cracking. All right, y'all, fading it on up. Oh shit, the workstation, fading it on up. All right, and we peeling the tape back slowly, slowly. I usually like to peel it back when it's still wet, but this is hours later. Oops, sorry about that. Yeah. Looking good. I'm gonna let the front, I just put another coat on the front. And usually what I'll do is I'll put the, I'll leave some old spark plugs down in there. Yeah, a lot of love went into these, man. A lot of love. See, when you use a masking tape, I try to seal it up real good, but you know, it gets past. But all I'll do once it dries, is take some acetone and just hit it right quick, cause this surface is smooth. But yeah, we looking good, man. We looking real good. I'll leave this all on and peel it tomorrow. I did an okay job. Nah, I did a bullshit job. I just wanted the surfaces to be clean where it's gonna touch. So you can see tape in there, tape in there, tape in there. And I went in just a little bit so that the blue would get covered. You feel me? But yeah, there we go, gang. I've got some roller tip heads. My bad, roller tip heads. I got some roller tip rockers. I think I might put those in. And then this, I have some crane golds for this one. I just gotta find them. But yeah, gang. There it is. I'm gonna fade it back on out. And I'll probably wait till the morning and finish this video out. Because I actually want to set it on the block and see how everything looks. So I think that's what I'll do, gang. I'm gonna fade it on out and I'll bring you guys, set you guys down for a few hours, and by the morning this will be nice and dry. For a homegrown backyard boogie, gang, this is cool. You feel me? This will work. Yeah, and then what I'll do right now is I can't fuck with the frame because I can't see, it's dark out here, but that'll be tomorrow's project. So I'll be finishing up this video tomorrow when the sun comes up, and then I'll be starting videos on the frame for this one. So all right, gang, I'm gonna fade you guys out, and yeah, it'll be morning time when I see you next. All right, gone. All right, gang, I couldn't wait. I wanted to see what it looked like. That's gonna be clean in her setup. I'm not gonna end the video here. I'm gonna get a dayside video, pull it all out. And yeah, man, that is going to, man, I dig the LS's, man. You know what I'm saying? This is just the way to go. But man, it's something about these old school motors that I dig. just like that look, you know. That's what I was trying to recreate with, you know, with this one. I just like the look of the old school valve cover. It's just that whole, you know, the carburetor. I just dig the way it looks. But what's dope about it is it's a EFI, man. But yeah, gang, so this is gonna work out great. My fuel line will come up, boom, hit right there. Clean fuel will be coming in. Remade that line because I needed it to be just a little bit longer. So we remade the line. That came out nice. Just kind of mocking stuff up. I don't think she's going to be able to run that spacer. I have a 1-inch spacer that I ran on this before, and I don't think her hood's going to clear that. So we gonna have to, we'll see. And this is an RPM air gap, so it's already up tall. You feel me? So yeah, but there it is, gang. So I'm a fade it back on out, and tomorrow when the sun is out, be out in about 3 hours. It's about 3:30 in the morning. I'll pull it back out and get after it, finish the video up. I'll paint this up tomorrow as well, and that'll be it for the motor for now. And then we're gonna get on this frame today. So today is Tuesday, and that's what we're gonna be on. So be on the lookout for that video coming. All right, y'all, fading it on out. And we fading it right back on in, gang. I ain't even gonna lie to you. Shit, I ain't done nothing today. It's already 4:04, man. But here we go. It's a clean look. I really wanted to color match it, but I just put it back to the way it was when it was in here. This is exactly how it looked. I throw the air cleaner on top, and that's exactly what I had in the Monte Carlo. So yeah, this is like looking at it back in 2008. Yeah, of course everything is just mocked up. It's just set on there. I went ahead and secured one of the heads down. I'm just gonna keep a bag over it until I get back to it. We're waiting for all the seals to come, you know, so I can, the gaskets and all that stuff to come, so we can get that cracking. Still need to paint the front. What I'm about to get after now is this over here. See, I don't think I wanted it black because I have the all blacked out. No, this is all blacked out, and this is black with a little chrome. But that'll look good inside there. You feel me? But yeah, gang, so we're gonna go on ahead and end this vid. I gotta start getting it cleaned up in here. My guy Chili P Performance said that the gas tanks will be ready soon. I got a new gas tank for this one. That 22-gallon tank is new that's in there. It's gonna go with this motor and that carburetor. So the fuel line, everything that's in there is coming right on out. So he says that those tanks are done. The other tank is for the Malibu. And I gotta get it cleaned up in here because I gotta put it somewhere. So maybe I'll get rid of some of that stuff up there and stick them over there. We'll figure it out. But yeah, gang, what we gonna do now is pull this frame out and start working on that. I got some goodies coming for the welding rig, gang. So I've been watching. That's why, I couldn't go to sleep. Mine's just racing. I've been watching all kinds of Eastwood videos and just customer, you know, that have this particular rig. Been watching their videos, a lot of how-to MIG videos. And I had actually got pretty good with the flux welder a while back. But I fell off, so I'm gonna have to get back on it. But things will be a lot easier with this 75-25 argon mix, argon CO2 mix. You know, it's all about controlling the with your style. You know, some people like to push, some people like to drag it. Is that the stick out, and the chart really makes it easy. So we'll be getting on that, gang. Because I really want to finish this frame up, man. The other thing is I got a plasma cutter down there from Eastwood as well. So we can do a lot of stuff once I learn how to use it all properly. So, but there it is, gang. I'm gonna end the video, man. Appreciate you riding along with your little homie. We got it done, and we just waiting for a few things so we can completely button it all up. Rim flex gaskets, all the gaskets for just everything. Everything's, we tore it all apart. So, but there it is, gang. It's your boy up in the messy ass rock shop, aka Chevy Country, where we most definitely keep it Chevy.